Hi viewers, how are you? Last class we have seen introduction to chemistry. Now today we'll see about common laboratory apparatus and equipments. Okay, this is lesson number 2, common laboratory apparatus and equipments. Introduction of this is chemistry is incomplete without experiments. Chemistry is incomplete without experiments. Without experiments, chemistry is incomplete. For experiments, we need some of the equipments. For that, we should use laboratory. Understood? For chemistry is incomplete without experiments. For that, we need some special equipments that will be available in the laboratory. So, what is chemistry? Chemistry, knowledge of chemistry is based on ability to observe what we are observing and put into experiments. Then we should come to the conclusion result. Observation is based on our sense organs by seeing, hearing, touch, taste and smell. For that we will be using visualizing by using eyes and hearing by using our ears, smelling. Smell by using our nose and touch and feel. Actually, we should not touch the substances. For that we are saying, and so then taste also we should not do. We should not taste the chemicals. Based on this observation by using our sense organs, we can come to the conclusions by using some special apparatus, that is some special equipments that will be available in the laboratory, lab. Okay, then for example, in daily life we observe that sun rises in the east side and sun sets in the west, that is our observation. Our rolling ball will fall down, that is also our observation. Such observation help us to draw scientific conclusions, as Newton found that apple has come down from the tree, fallen down from the tree. From that he has derived the gravitational force of an earth. So, but all the observations will not give scientific factors, but most of the observations help us to find scientific conclusions, isn't it? Then one more examples, farmers will do. How will they separate the good grains and bad grains? Okay, wasted grains. If we observe in the house, mother will be start cooking, but she will not be straight away put the rice in the rice cooker. Instead that, she will be washing that rice twice or thrice by removing the lighter waste particle. In that same way, farmers will drain, that is farmers will better. Farmers will keep it in water, the grains, so that the heavier particles, good grains, will be settling down. Bad grains, wasted, damaged seeds will be hollow and that will be lighter, so that will be float on the water and they will be throwing that out and they will be separating the good grains to sow seeds. Understood? Then, so the importance of observation, this is by observing from the earlier, that is the elder person, we are observing this and we are coming to the conclusions. In that way we should use our sense organs to observe the things around us for the experiment. But all that cannot be understood by our surroundings. Some of that need laboratory, that is chemistry is a branch of science which is mostly based on the experiments under controlled condition. Is an activity where we observe natural or artificial created phenomenon activity. For example, if you are doing an experiment, that is activity, by using hot water and cooled water, we are taking three glasses of water, one named that as A, B, C, and one is containing hot water, boiled water, next one is lukewarm water, temperature will be low. Okay, lukewarm water, and one glass will be containing cold water. If we are at a time keeping our fingers on both the tumblers, hot water and cold water, and insert in the deep glass, that is the middle lukewarm water, which is in the hot water. This finger, left finger, will be feeling that this water is cold. B glass contain, compared to this hot water, compared to this hot water, lukewarm water will be cold and the temperature will be lower one. And compared to this cold water in the right hand side, she'll be feeling this water will be hot, a little bit hotter than this water. So this chemistry is an hotness or coldness, feeling of hotness or coldness or the relative terms. So in chemical laboratory, the experiment says, based on the observed chemical laboratory performing experiments, to observe experiments, to analyze the result, she'll be comparing and say this is hotter than this. A contains hotter than B and C contains colder than B. So this is comparative terms. So experimental science is comparative. She is taller than Nivi. She is fatter than Renu. Okay, in that same way, that is comparative, relative terms. Next one, various kinds of apparatus and equipments are required to perform experiments. Okay, most of the things we will be needing, many more things to perform experiments. Necessary precautions should be taken while performing experiments. We should wear usually cotton dresses that will not be catch fire easily, and we should not touch and taste any substances in the lab. These are all the precautions, and we should use exhaust fan to remove the drain out the bad gaseous. And in the same way, maintain silence. For observation, we need silence. Maintain silence and discipline in the laboratory and concentrate on your experiments. Every minute particle is important, and that in the same way, every drop, single drop, is very essential for the accurate results. So we should concentrate on our experiment. Then concept of the lesson, various kinds. What is the main concept of this lesson? Various kinds of apparatus and equipment in laboratory, in chemistry laboratory. First, we should know the name of that, so that it will be easier for us our applications while we do our experiments. First one is working table. Working table in the laboratory will be having fitted with the reagent cell. Reagent cell in the sense, each table will be containing a separate cupboard, that is separate almirah, open cupboard. So it will be containing, that is reagent cell, that is known as reagent cell, and sink to wash our hand or equipments. Okay, usually to wash our apparatus, and a waste paper basket. Each table will be having a provide with the waste paper basket, and there is a side cell for keeping glassware. This is side cell, cell in the sense cupboard, to keep the glassware, open cupboards, those are all okay, to keep the glassware, apparatus, and fume closet. Fume closet, the concentrated acids will be emit fume, so it will be in the closed container, that is called a fume closet. Okay, this is the first one. First one is working table. Working table will be having the reagent cell, sink, waste paper basket, and we have aware of the side cell, which will be having glassware and apparatus. Apparatus in the sense, pipette, burette, conical flask, beakers, whatever that is. Then fume closet. Fume closet, it will be in the closed bay. Then second one is reagent shelf. Reagent shelf will be containing the reagents with the names written on the properly. Okay, why it should be written on the names labeled? That is, there should not be any confusion while using the reagent. For that purpose, the reagent bottles will be labeled. Understood? Next one, Third one, exhaust fan. Exhaust fan is essential that will be fitted with the roof to expel poisonous gas and fumes so that we can breathe easily and we can be comfortable for a long time in the lab. Next one, balance room. Balance room to balance, to weigh the chemicals that will be in the physical balance and nowadays digital balance also available. We'll see about this later. Next, important things. We are in the chemistry lab. These will be on the preliminary things should be there. Okay, some of the basic chemical equipments and apparatus are test tube. You would have been aware of the test tubes will be like this, and it is used to conduct tests in small quantities. For using chemicals, will be applying only very a point drop, that is a drop of chemicals will be used. If it is a solid, a pinch of solid will be used, not a big spoon. Okay, very small quantity will be used, so the test tubes will be in the smaller size to hold that. Then this will be usually in the chemistry lab, the things will be, apparatus will be made by glass. This is Pyrex glass or borosil glass, is a special type of glass which hardly expands on heating. Such glasses do not break even at a high temperature. Okay, then we'll be having the question, why should we use the glass apparatus in the laboratory? It will be easy to note the numbers. It will be easy to clean the apparatus easily. For that purposes, we'll be using glass apparatus. Then test tube stand. For test tube, we have seen, and we cannot have that test tube in the slanting way. For that, we'll be needing a strand. We cannot keep it lie down on this, on the table with the solutions. So it need a test tube strand. For that purpose, it will be made up of wooden. In the olden days by wooden, nowadays using plastics. Okay, to keep the test tubes in the organized way. If it is used one, it can be kept in the straight way. Otherwise, if it is unused test tubes, we can keep upside down to clean up the water, to dry the water. Next one, test tube holder. We have seen, as we are cooking, we will be heating the chemicals, substances in the lab. For that purpose, as we are using tongs in the house to hold whistles, it is called as test tube holder to fit in this, and will be carrying the test tubes. Hot test tubes cannot carry by the bare hand, so we should have the test tube holder. It has three parts, such as clamp. It is clamp at the one end, and this is iron rod, and a handle on the other end. This is clamp to open and fit with the test tube, and this is the middle part. This is iron rod, and the other end is made up of wood to hold, handle to hold in our hand. Next, about beakers. Beakers will be in the different sizes, 50, 100, 250, 500 ml, to prepare and keeping of solution. Next one. Fifth is the flask. Flask is three types of flask usually. This is round bottom flask, then that is a flat bottom flask and a conical flask. To hold sufficient quantities, we can have a 250, 200, 100 ml of quantity. So this is called sufficient quantities of substances. Understood? This is round bottom flask, and this is flat bottom flask, and then third conical flask to do the experiments. Then measuring cylinder. This is a cylindrical apparatus measured in milliliters or deciliters to measure the volume of the liquid substances. Then this is measuring jar to measure and pour it in the flask, okay, or a beaker, whatever that is. Then funnel. Funnel will be cone shaped. That will be cone shaped as we are folding the paper into cone shape. This is cone shaped with the stem. This is stem and a narrow end made up of glass or plastic. Plastic. Nowadays plastic also available because the children, students will not be getting damaged the hand or whatever that is that body. So nowadays plastics also available. It is used to filter and transfer liquids from one container to another container without any drop of wastage. While we are transferring the liquids, we should not waste even a single drop, and that will cause a major error in our experiments. So without any single particle, wastage of single particle or wastage of any single drop, we should do the experiments for the correct values. Then evaporating dish, it is a bowl shaped container made by porcelain. It is used for evaporating solution. While we are evaporating, we use this porcelain bowls. As we are getting snacks at home, no, in that shape only, that is a shaped container, bowl shaped only, that is. So this is made by porcelain, so we should handle with care. It will be easily breakable. Glass or this porcelain will be easily breakable, but we should handle with care. Then mortar and pestle, it is used to, made by porcelain, is used to crush the solid substances into powder. While we do the experiments, we may get solids also. To crush into small pieces, we need mortar and pestle. Next one. 10th one is tripod stand. Tripod stand, as we have seen at home, we are using stand to hold the small vessels, no? In that same way, in the laboratory also available tripod stand. While we are using burner, beaker will not be fit on the burner, isn't it? This is the burner, this is spirit lamp. It cannot straight away keep on that burner or spirit lamp. So we should use the tripod stand and wire gauze on that. So this is also hollow one, no? So we should cover this tripod stand using this wire gauze. On the top of that, we place a beaker to heat that. Understood? So that is called tripod stand. This is made by iron to hold the apparatus. Then wire gauze. Wire gauze, this is the iron mesh. And in the middle, it is made by asbestos. Why should we use this? It will be spreading, that heat will be spread on the vessel uniformly. For that purpose, we use wire gauze. Then spirit lamp. Spirit lamp will be made by this, that is metal or glass. Fuel is spirit. Spirit is used as a fuel in this, and over that we should use this tripod stand and use wire gauze. After that, we can keep a heat, that is a beaker. If it is a heating test tube, we can use the test tube holder and we can straight away show it on the flame. Okay, then next one, Bunsen burner. It is a burner that use gas as a fuel. As we are using at home, gas only the fuel of this. It is used for heating purposes, and these are all the that is parts of the Bunsen burner. This is barrel or chimney, and this is flame, outer cone and inner cone. Here rubber tubing, as we are using in the household purposes, we are using rubber tube in that same way, and this inside, this gas will be passed through. Then air, circulation of air is essential to make flame. So this air will be passing through this, and that should be air regulated, that should be in the proper way. For that, adjustment will be there, collar will be there. Then this is air hole. Okay, then this is a gas valve to open and close this gas valve. This is base of that This is Bunsen burner and this is the base of that. This is gas valve to open and close. As we are using home, it is a rubber tube will be there and gas will be passing into through this, and air will be necessary to, air circulation is necessary for that. This is the air hole and air will be passing through. To adjust that air collar, it can be adjusted by threading that. Then barrel of chimney, this is chimney and flame will be there. Next one, reagent bottle. As we have seen, it is made by white or colored glasses. Colored glasses, some of the substances will be evaporated when for sunlight, so those will be kept in the colored glasses. This reagent bottles used to storing chemicals, understood? Then gas jar will be used, that is white color glass cylinder used to collecting gases. While we collecting gases doing experiment, it can be used. It is called as gas jar. Then analytical balance, we have seen already about the balance. This is manual balance. It will be having two pads and both the sides will be having two pads. It is used to measure the weight of the chemicals manually. In the sense, we are doing our own, we have to balance that by using grams, as the vegetable vendor doing, we can do. Okay, it is for a small quantity, as I said, that is the milligrams, so we can use the smaller weights, not as 2 kilograms, 3 kilograms, 200, 300, that way we'll be weighing. So this is the analytical balance, and nowadays the digital balance is available in the lab. It is a single plate only. As we are operating the switches, we can weigh easily. The substances will be weighed on the paper and it can be weighed easily. Then the room should be kept, balanced room should be kept clean from the dust and smoke, so that we can get the exact weighing of the substances. Then glass tube. What is glass tube? Made of glass and it is used to transfer liquid or gases from one container to another one, like a straw, bent straw. It is made up of glass. So this is glass tube, understood? Next one, glass rod, made by glass. As we have said, that is glass rod, it is made by glass, and it is, as we are ladle in the kitchen, we are using spoons, ladle, no? In that same way, it will be using to stir the chemicals. We should not use our hands at all. Okay, so to stir that evenly, it will be using glass rods, will be using, and at that same time, while we are transferring from one container to another container, we'll be using this through the glass rod we should transfer, so that that is no wastage will be there. As I said, even single particle will be making much difference in values, so it should be passed through the glass rod, and it will be using for the stirring purposes, as we are using scoops in the kitchen to kindle the food. It will be using to evenly spreading, it will be using to kindle in the laboratory. Okay, next, dropper, made up of glass, used to transfer liquids. We said already, very small quantities will be taken, so how can we take, not using the scoops, isn't it? So we'll be using dropper, understood? Next one, watch glass is everything, is most of the things will be made by glass only. This is made up of glass to collect small amount of substances, or we can use to close the beakers to collect vapors. When we are doing experiments to close the beakers, we can use this watch glass, or for taking out a small quantity of substances, we can use this substances, that is the watch glass, as a small glass plate. Okay, it will be available in two different sizes, to close the 50 ml, 100 ml beakers, and to close this 5 to 5500 ml beakers, isn't it? Then crucible and cover. Crucible, it is made up of porcelain. It is used to when substance require strong heating. When substance require strong heating, it will be, the substance will be placed in the porcelain and closed with the lid, and we should keep it in the oven for heating. Okay, then water trough. Water trough, it is made up of glass or metal to collect glass, collect gas. When we are doing collecting water, we'll be using this water trough. Then review of the lesson. Chemistry is a branch of science which is mostly based on experiments under controlled condition. Knowledge of chemistry is based on experiment and observation. Various kinds of apparatus and equipments are required to perform experiments. We have seen the name of the experiment, that is name of the apparatus, and we'll be having question in this assessment and this. Match the following. Iron strand. Match the following. First one is iron strand, test tube, funnel, beaker, glass rod. Here, to boil chemicals, to keep solution, to stir the solution, to support apparatus, to transfer the liquids. First one, iron strand will be using to support apparatus. Second one, test tube, to boil chemicals. When we are heating, taking small quantities of substances to boil the chemicals, test tube will be useful. Then third one, funnel. Funnel, when we'll be using in the house also for a milk cooker, they are providing a small funnel to keep water in the milk cooker, isn't it? In that same way, funnel to transfer the liquid from one container to the another one. Next one, beaker. What is the purpose of beaker? To keep the solutions. Beaker to keep the solution. Then glass rod, to stir the solution. As we are using scoops at home to kindle our food, taking our food, glass rod to stir the solution. Understood? Shall we see the next question? That is, why are most apparatus made of glass in the laboratories? Most of the laboratory apparatus is made of glass because this glass is easy to clean. Glass is transparent material and we can see through it clearly. We can read out the reading clearly. It does not react with most of the chemicals used in experiment. It is most important, okay, that container should not react with the chemicals. If it react with the chemicals, we will be getting incorrect values. Then glass withstands high temperature. Borosil Pyrex glass will be having high temperature, so it can be used. Pyrex glass and borosil glass is a special type of glass which hardly expands on heating. Such glasses do not break even at high temperature. Then next question, list any 5 precautions taken care while performing an experiment in a chemical laboratory. We can write any 5 precautions. We will be by hearting whatever, that is 7, 8 we have. Whichever easier for us, we will be writing and scoring the marks. Do not touch or taste any unknown substances in the lab. This is most important because those are all poisonous. So should not touch or taste any unknown substances. Then use only small quantity of chemical to carry out experiments. As I said, a very small drop, 1 drop or 2 drops is enough to do the experiment, or a pinch of solid substance is enough to carry out the experiment. Do not work alone in the laboratory. So as your young one, you will not be aware of the bad things about that. So we should not be alone in the laboratory without any elder supervision in the lab. Then do not throw hot concentrated hazards into the sink directly. It will be damaging that sink and it may be, you may also get that fume on your face. So should not, don't throw hot concentrated acids into the sink directly. Nowadays the outlet pipes will be made by the plastics. If it is not in good quality, it will be make hole on that and there will be pouring down, that may hurt us. Okay, we may be getting damaged our, if we are legs are down to that sink, it is we getting damaged. Then always wear an apron in the laboratory to protect your clothes. Okay, first one, we should wear cotton dresses on the practical days. Second one, wearing apron or a laboratory coat, white coat, as doctors wearing white color coat can be used, or instead of that, apron is enough to protect our clothes. While heating, keep the mouth of test tube away from your eyes and face, and we should not keep the test tube closer to our chest or mouth or face. It should keep at the one hand distances to do the experiments. Okay, at that same time, you should not make any hurt to your neighbors also. One hand distances from the from any person, yourself or your neighbors. Then the apparatus to be used in the experiment should be arranged neatly before beginning an experiment. Before we start the experiments, we should arrange the apparatus neatly for our convenience. Do not throw broken glass apparatus or used filter paper in the sink. Throw them in the dustbin. Whatever the waste in the laboratory, should not throw it in the sink. Only washing purpose we should use sink. For other purposes we should use dustbin. Then label the marked equipments in the diagram given below. We have seen many of the apparatus names. In that you should name the apparatus name in this, equipment's name in this. What is this? First one is delivery tube. First one is delivery tube. Next one is, this is the round bottom flask. We can write flask on round bottom flask. Third one is, on heating purposes we are using, that is wire gas. Then fourth one is tripod stand. This is a tripod stand. Then fifth one is Bunsen burner, isn't it? This is question, this is answer, Bunsen burner. Then sixth one is, what is this? Gas jar to collect the gas. This is only gas circles one, no? This will be gases emitting the gas. This one, gas jar. Then seventh one is water trough to hold the water. Then eighth one is water filled up with the water. Understood? So far we have completed the lesson, common laboratory apparatus and equipments. With the next lesson, matter, we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.